Hey guys, so I'm continuing to talk about the topic of comparing the two professions, psychology and social work. And the first thing that really comes to mind is, you know, people who are in the process of pursuing these two kinds of degrees, or these two professions. Which one is for you? That's the kind of, which one is better? I guess that's like the obvious question to ask, simply because the topic, the title that I put for this topic is psychology versus social work. The versus there is kind of a misnomer, but I am comparing the two. But it's not like a fight between the two professions. I respect psychology. I am a social work major, so I do have a bias towards this field. But psychology is a more established field, and I respect it for that. The school of psychology is older than school of social work, and you know, so much respect for psychology. I do not mean to, by the title of this, I do not mean to, you know, demean any psychologists or the field of psychology. There's no intention of that whatsoever. There's just discussion of the commonalities between the two fields and the differences between the two fields. So let's talk about degrees, pursuing psychology and pursuing social work. So statistically speaking, if you are pursuing psychology, you have kind of a long road ahead of you because, unfortunately, statistically speaking, any field of psychology, whether that be social psychology, psychology, family psychology, ego psychology, feminist psychology, I think that's even a whatever, but there's all kinds of psychology. Unfortunately, if you are pursuing psychology, you have to be aware of the fact that, well, it's the degree with the most unemployment, the highest unemployment rate, is people who graduated with psychology degree. It's about, depending on what kind of psychology it is, it ranges from 13% to 16% of graduates with psychology degree are unemployed, which is quite a number to think about. It actually makes sense, because if you want to get anywhere with psychology, bachelor's in psychology really doesn't open up many opportunities. There are some opportunities that open up there. I mean, you can be a research assistant. You can kind of work as a hospital as a some kind of an aide to psychologists. But those are like super entry level, low positions you can get as a psychology major. Which is the same thing with social work. If you have a bachelor's in social work, in almost all parts of the country, you're not going to get anything. And that was my situation. I have a bachelor's in social work, and I had a hard time finding a job in anything, especially in New York City. Of course, if I was in Tennessee or if I was in Alabama, Arkansas, in those rural southern states, bachelor's in social work means a lot. But then again, because social work is so, there's less of a standard there in regards to social work in the southern states, so it would have been easier to find actual social work field jobs. But it requires much more experience. So that's kind of the dilemma. Once you graduate from college, any degree, once you graduate from college with a bachelor's, the dilemma is this. Your degree, you have a degree, right? That's a one-up from people with just a high school degree. Sure. But when you apply to jobs, the employers want people with a degree that fits their field. So, you know, if you want to work in a mental health institution, you know, they want people with degrees in social work and they want people with degrees in psychology. Those two go in hand in that field. But they also want people with experience. They want people with 2 years or 3 years or 4 years of experience working in that field. If you graduated from college with either of those degrees, chances are you're not going to have any experience. When you compare bachelor's in social work to bachelor's in psychology, social work has a hand up because social work, at least in the schools that I know about and schools I've been into, mandates. Internship is mandatory to get a degree in social work. You have to have at least 21 hours a week of internship for the fourth year of the pursuing your degree. NYU does. The school I went to not only required the fourth year, but also the second half of the third year. So By the time I graduated with a bachelor's in social work, I already have about 700 hours of internship, of experience. So that's why social work has a one-up. Psychology doesn't require an internship, but it does require, you know, you do research studies and experiments. Yeah, so that in that way, psychology has a hand up because you know, for more research-based fields, if a mental institution wants a research assistant, they're going to pick people with a psychology degree more than someone with a social work degree. So it has a hand up in the research department. That's bachelor's. You can't really get anything, right? Now, master's. When you compare someone who has a master's in psychology and master's in social work, social workers are set. They can now start their career as social workers. And that master's means so much. It's an accredited degree. Also, if you decide to take, and you should, so if you pursue social work and you have a master's degree, immediately consider taking the exam, the social work exam. After you take the exam and you pass it, you're licensed. So your degree goes from MSW to LMSW, and that means a lot. Because now, the entry-level positions you can enter with an LMSW, you can even get into supervisor position. So you can be a supervisor in a field setting or in a nonprofit organization, a private nonprofit or government nonprofit, it doesn't matter. You can even go into corporate social work. You can go into hospitals, which are in America, I don't know about anyone else, but hospitals in America are mostly for-profit organizations. And if you go into hospitals, you make a lot of money as social workers. So you're set with the master's degree. In fact, with an LMSW, you can even, I don't know about LMSW. Maybe that's not the case. Alright, forget that. I don't think that's the case with LMSW. But if you have a master's degree in social work and you work 3 years, so you accrue 3 years of experience with your MSW, you can choose to take the exam and change it into LMSW, or you can choose not to. But after 3 years, you can also choose to, and you have to remember, those 3 years has to be under a social work supervisor. So after you work 3 years, you can take another exam, the clinical social work exam. After that, if you pass it, you can change your MSW into something called LCSW, which is Licensed Clinical Social Work. If you do that, oh boy, you are set. Now you can be a clinical social worker. So you can open up a private practice. You can open up, you know, an office of your own, and you can be a therapist, a private therapist with a master's in social work. Now, if you have a master's in psychology, and a lot of people who go into psychology want to be that kind of person, you know, they want to be a private psychologist or a private therapist. Master's doesn't cut it for psychology. You have to get a doctorate. If you have a master's in psychology, the roads that are open to you is not as open as social work. And I think that's why when you get into this kind of discussion about, you know, master's in psychology versus MSW. MSW is like, there's advantage here. So almost everything psychology related, you need a doctorate to get anywhere. Master's in psychology is impressive, but if you want to work in your field, it's still hard. It's still very, very hard. It would feel like you have a bachelor's in social work and you want to do something social work related. It's kind of like that with the master's in psychology. There's still a lot of things you can do. You know, my closest friend has a master's in psychology, and she's working as a discharge planner for people who recently were incarcerated in a prison, and now they're out. So she's a discharge planner for people. And those people who they also have mental illness. So she's kind of working in her field, but it's not really something that people like pursuing psychology degree would be really into. You know, she wants to work with people who have severe mental illnesses, people with borderline personality disorder, schizophrenia, and all of that stuff. So she's not satisfied where she is because she has a master's in psychology. You know, if you want to be like really awesome psychology jobs, you know, a profiler in the FBI, a private therapist, psychiatrist, although that's going to take a lot of years of schooling compared to just psychologists, a researcher, you know, a person who conducts psychology experiments, you need a doctorate for psychology. And when you compare Social work, if you want a job in social work, you don't need a doctorate at all. You can just have master's and that'll be it for you. The only reason you would pursue doctorate in social work, a DSW, would be if you want to become a professor in a school of social work, or if you want to, you know, write papers for the field of social work. If you want to do research in social work, doctorate, you need that. You want that prestige. But you don't need it in social work. You don't need a doctorate to pursue social work. If what you want to do is social work. Psychology, you kind of need a doctorate. And when you compare doctorate in psychology to doctorate in social work, well, that's where you have this huge gap. Doctorate, if you pit them against, if this is like a fight where, you know, the field of psychology has a sword, or okay, fine. If it's a fight between the two, it's like the doctorate in psychology has a machine gun. And it's like the doctorate of social work just has a sword and a shield, maybe. So if you're comparing doctorate, psychology all the way, but if we're going by degrees, you know, and doctorate in psychology, there's also that, and there's also doctorate in psychiatry. And that is like a bazooka, you know, I don't know, a rocket launcher. So there's that, you know, bachelor's in both, bachelor's in psychology versus bachelor's in social work, not much difference in terms of prestige or what you're able to do. Master's in psychology versus master in social work. Master's in social work, master's in psychology is like right here. So there's a lot of advantages here. This, now they can start their careers. If you're a master's in psychology, you still there's many avenues you can go to, but you still can't really start your psychology career. And this is when we have doctorate in psychology and doctorate in social work. Doctorate in social work is great. You know, you get a lot of prestige. You can be a professor. You can write papers, peer-reviewed papers, and all that stuff. So it's up there. You can be a researcher. Yeah, and you can even get into policy. So that's pretty cool. But this is where, you know, doctorate in psychology is like, boom. You know, now they are doctors and awesome stuff. You know, they can really do whatever they want to do. It just means that if you're a psychology major, you just have to be prepared for a lot of school. Because if you want to get anywhere in your field, unfortunately, you need a doctorate. That's why it makes sense to me that psychology as a field has such a high unemployment rate. Because a lot of people stop at master's. A lot of people stop at bachelor's. And if you have a bachelor's or master's in psychology, sorry, but there's the roads that are open for you, not that many open. And also, it's a very competitive field once you're a doctor. Because now it feels like there's so many doctors in psychology that want to start their career. So that's why it's a highly competitive field once you get there. But it's an important field, and comparatively speaking, you know, if you pursue a degree in psychology, and you know you get your doctorate and you find your field, you start doing psychology, you're gonna make so much more money than a person who does social work. So money wise, prestige wise, you know, psychology is the way to go. You just gotta prepare for a lot of school. If you're a psychiatrist and you work in a hospital, you're gonna make a ton of money, and compared to a regular doctor. You're going to be sued a lot less. So there's much less money to invest in malpractice insurance, which is good, which is very, very good. You're just going to have to deal with a lot of crazy people, but people who go into psychology love working with crazy people. I certainly do as a social work major, and my friend who is a psychology major certainly do as well. That's kind of our thing. We find that fun. I know, we're weird, but we find that fun working with people who society would not even dare to approach. This is our field, you know? And that's where the commonality is between social work and psychology.